Let's do another related rates problem. So once again, I have just listed out here the steps for doing related rates. And so let's go ahead and work through these steps, starting off by reading the problem, drawing a picture or diagram if we can, and then determining the relationship between the variables. This should say variables. We normally have more than one variable. Variables are the quantities that are discussed, and then actually form an equation from those relationships. So we've looked at a variety of examples at this point, but I did want to do one more. And so let's take a look at this one. So if we have a kite 100 feet above the ground, moves horizontally at a speed of 8 feet per second, and then we're asked what rate is the angle between the string and the horizontal decreasing when 200 feet of string has been let out. So we've talked quite a bit in this section now about how we're going to be given a snapshot in time. And if you think about a kite as you're letting string out, there's only a moment, an instant in time when it hits that 200 feet of string being let out. So that's really just a snapshot. That's the time that we're being asked the question for. And our answer is likely to be different if we wanted to know what it would be when there was only 2 feet or 10 feet or 100 feet or 300 feet of string. So we kind of keep that in mind, that that's a snapshot in time. That is not a fixed constant. Whereas this 100 feet, a kite is 100 feet above the ground, and that is a constant. That's a fixed value in our scenario. So let's go ahead and do our organization and our labeling of variables and then come up with our equation. We're talking about angles here, so I think this is going to have some fun trig for us to work with here. So here's like a little person. You know, the scenario here is kind of silly because technically we're thinking of the string being like directly on the ground. But so I don't know. I guess you could have like a person like laying on the ground looking up at the sky. Sorry, I'm getting kind of silly here. Laying on the ground looking up at the sky. And then here's the kite, and might as well make it pretty little color here. So here's our kite, little rainbow kite flying up here. Actually, my rainbow crayon turned out all red. And we're talking about this angle, the angle that the kite actually, I guess it would be going. Let's go that way from the horizontal up. Let's call that theta. So theta is going to be equal to, as we start labeling here, theta is going to be the angle between the string and the horizontal. I guess I could have drawn my little person standing up and just said, let's let the horizontal be their, you know, the line from their hand. So there we go. That makes more sense. We'll call that horizontal there. And we are told that the kite flies at a above the ground at 100 feet. So this is a fixed 100 feet. So it's just sort of being blown along the ground. Let's go ahead and call this X right here. And we do know that we're moving this way. So basically X is the horizontal distance. So let's say horizontal distance. And let's go ahead and call this guy Y. Those two are changing. Actually, all three of the variables we have so far are changing in this scenario. X is changing as the wind sort of blows this kite this direction. X is changing, as is Y. Y is the amount of string. Amount of string from the hand to the kite. Okay, so that is the amount of string. All right. So now that we've labeled the variables, let's come up with what is the relationship or the equation. Between these quantities. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what we can come up with between these quantities. And you know, while we're here, let's go ahead, we'll do these kind of hand in hand over here. Let's write out the known values. I always write known values, but technically I also like to list at the very bottom what it is I'm actually looking for. So the known values at the snapshot in time. Okay. So at the snapshot in time that we're given, it says, what rate is the angle between the string and the horizontal? So we actually want to know what rate d theta dt is going to be when 200 feet of string has been let out. So that is a y value. So the snapshot in time, our little snapshot, is when y equals 200. So that's when we're going to like freeze this scenario and actually consider what's happening to that angle. So when y equals 200 is the snapshot that we're looking at. So we'd be looking at a moment in time where this would be the triangle we'd be considering. And because I'm going to use a triangle to come up with some other information, I'm going to go ahead and write it. So this is the snapshot in time, that triangle right there. Now we also know that the wind is blowing or the kite is moving at a rate that makes the horizontal, the distance that is increasing horizontally as that kite moves, dx dt is moving at a rate of 8 feet per second. And we are asked to find d theta dt. That is the question. Okay. All right, so if we have dx dt and we want to find, let's go ahead and circle what we want to find in red here. We want to find d theta dt. There are lots of relationships that we could write here. Like we could say x squared plus y squared equals, that's not right. X squared, the sum of the two legs, x squared plus 100 squared equals y squared. There we go. Get my Pythagorean triangle there correct. X squared plus 100 squared equals y squared. That's one relationship that we have. We have several trig ratios that we could write. For instance, the tangent of theta is equal to 100 over x, but we could also write that the sine of theta is equal to 100 over y, or the cosine of theta is equal to x over y. So notice that there are, right, I'm listing out all the relationships here, but the reason I wrote our known values down as I kind of went through the problem, I jumped to my third column here and started writing down the known values, is we have to decide which one of these we want to use to come up with the related rates equation. And so if I bring my eye over here and I see dx dt and I know I want d theta dt, I am going to want to use the relationship between the variables we have that relates both theta and x, because I know something about how x is changing, and what I want is a relationship with how d theta dt is changing. Okay. All right, so once we have that, knowing that I want x and theta, we'll come back to that snapshot in time. Let's go ahead and take the derivative. So now let's find the related rates equation. So let's find the related rates equation by differentiating with respect to time. Okay. Now, remember, if I had used any of these other scenarios that I had, any of these other relationships, and these are all true relationships, and if we were wanting to know, the rate of change of how y was changing or something, then we would, the amount of string was changing with respect to time, then we might want to use one of those other relationships. But we really did. We wanted the angle. That's what we were asked to find. So we're going to take the derivative of tangent of theta, remembering that all of these variables that we've defined are in fact changing with respect to time. So when I take their derivatives with respect to time, I have to apply that chain rule principle and multiply by their rate of change. So the derivative of tangent is secant squared of theta, but then I have to multiply by d theta dt. How is that angle changing with respect to time? D theta dt. And then I have to also take the derivative of 100 over x. I'm going to think about that as 100 times x to the negative first, because that makes the derivative a little easier. I don't have to use quotient rule. I can just use power rule. So that becomes negative 100 times x to the negative 2. But then I have to multiply by dx dt, because of course x is changing with respect to time. So then my relationship for the rates becomes secant squared theta d theta dt equals negative 100 over x squared dx dt. Now we are looking for d theta dt, so I'm going to take this one step further and isolate d theta dt. So I have d theta dt isolated. The rate of change of the angle with respect to time is going to be negative 100 over x squared times dx dt divided by secant squared of the angle. So there is my equation for the rate of change of the angle. So now I need it at that snapshot in time. So right, I do all this work just to come up with what is the related rates equation and then isolate the related rate that I actually want. But then you have to consider your actual snapshot in time. So now we want to consider that snapshot in time. Now remember what we were told for the snapshot in time was that y, which is actually not in this equation, was equal to 200. What we don't have yet, we know that y, meaning the amount of string, was 200, but notice that we need x and we need theta in order to plug into this equation. So I'm going to come back up here. I drew that little picture of our snapshot. And we have enough information on that triangle if we know that that moment in time has an amount of string on the hypotenuse of 200. We have enough information to solve for both x and theta. And so that's what we're going to do next. So right here at the snapshot in time, we could start with, we'll do this in red since this is that snapshot in time, x squared plus 100 squared equals when we hit that 200 mark on the string let out from the kite. We would have x squared plus 100 squared equals 200 squared, or x squared equals 40,000 minus 10,000, which would mean x squared equals 30,000, or x equals plus or minus the square root of 30,000. So this is going to obviously be a distance. So we can first of all just cross off the minus. And then this is 3 times 10,000. So we could take the square root of 10,000, and this would be x is going to be 100 times the square root of 3, or approximately, 171? Let's go out. I don't know the square root of 3 that far out. So on the calculator, 100 square root 3. That is going to be, 173.21. So that is what, at that snapshot in time, that is what x is going to be approximately equal to. So remember, we need x and we need theta. We already know dx, dx dt. So we have dx dt. That's a constant rate. Now we know x. Highlight that at the snapshot in, at that exact moment in time, we know what the x value is. We also need to find theta. So how would we find theta for this scenario? So let's say we found x at the snapshot. Now we need to find theta so we can plug that in at this little snapshot in time. And you know what I'm looking at here? I'm looking at the sine of theta. There's a we could do it in a couple ways because we now also know that x at this moment in time is 100 root 3. We don't even have to approximate. We could say exactly 100 root 3. So there's a few different ways to do it with the trig ratios, but I'm going to go with sine. Sine of theta is equal to 100 over 200, which means that sine of theta equals 1/2, or that theta is exactly pi over 6. Because it's the inverse sine of 1/2. So right at that moment in time, that was cooked up pretty nicely for us to be one of those special triangles. But let's write that. Those were two separate calculations, so I'll divide it. So now we also know theta. We know that theta is pi over 6. At that moment in time, remember that these two values I have in red are changing. Those are definitely changing. They are changing. You know, let's even write this 200 in red because that was just at that snapshot in time. You know, do a different color or something like that to keep your mind on that. So now we come back down here. We know that the related rates formula that we've derived, d theta dt, is negative 100 over x squared. We know what x is now, times dx dt over the secant squared of theta. So now we can actually figure this out. D theta dt at 200 feet of string. Okay, so after 200 feet of string is let out, d theta dt is going to be negative 100 over x squared. Now we can put in our exact value, 100 times the square root of 3 squared, times dx dt, which is a constant, 8 feet per second. I'm going to drop the units. When we get done here, our units are going to be, we're talking about a rate of change in an angle, and our angles will always be in radians. So this will be radians per second. 8 over, and then in the bottom we have secant squared of pi over 6. And now we could go to the calculator and just plug this in and get an approximation. But since we've worked it and I put in the exact values, let's go ahead and just see what it comes out when we do exact values. And then we can approximate right at the very end. All right, so just finishing this out, negative 100. When I square that bottom, that's actually going to become 30,000 times 8 divided by, well, the secant squared of pi over 6 is 1 over the cosine squared of pi over 6. So if we're dividing by that, that's the same as multiplying by the cosine squared of pi over 6. So I'm going to go ahead and write that. And then we just have to simplify. So let's see here. So this becomes negative 1 over 300 times 8 times, well, the cosine of pi over 6 is root 3 over 2 squared. And so now we've got negative 1 over 300 times 8 times 3 over 4. I was pausing there for a second because I was thinking of simplifying, but then I noticed this simplification will be really nice. The 4s go in, 4 goes into 8, 2, so we get negative 2 over 100 or negative 1 over 50. Now we could have just gone to a calculator, but you know, just using our skills here, we can do that. And of course, that's equal to negative 0.02 if we wanted the decimal. So this is actually equal to, so d theta dt, the rate of change of the angle, is negative 1/50th radian per second or negative 0.02 radians per second. And that is at right when 200 feet of string has been let out. So that angle, and it is a negative, by the way, if we go back to the picture, it will be a negative because the angle is, as that string goes out, this angle is actually going down. You know, the further it gets out here, right here where we're looking at that angle, the further we go out, you know, if we were further out here, that angle is actually, you know, it's a rate of decrease. D theta dt is negative. Okay, it is going down. That angle is going down towards the horizontal as that string gets let out further and further. All right, so let's see if I can get that all on the screen at the end here so that we can see that. So again, remember, if we had looked at a different time, right, this one was cooked up really nicely at that snapshot in time so that our theta was pi over 6, and we could find our x value as well. But if we looked at it at a different moment in time, you know, possibly when that amount of string was 300 or 500 feet, then we would have a different rate of change in the angle with respect to time.